Okay, genetic variation. There are multiple ways that genes can vary and you know how this works, but some concepts that you want to take into account are mutation and reproduction. Mutation itself can alter, you know, the gene allele, just, you know, some freak mutation here and there, you know, just maybe swapping out, you know, some of the nucleotides or those kind of things. Now, the one that you really want to know a little bit more is the reproductive aspect of genetic variation. And these are really important to know. One of them happens to be independent assortment. And this happens during meiosis where these sister chromatids happen to line up, you know, at the plate. And these can line up in, you know, any assortment, you know, or order in which they choose. And, you know, this randomness of alignment kind of contributes to the genetic variation. Another way that it can contribute to genetic variation is something that we call crossing over. And when these two chromosomes, you see how they're crossing over right here, and then the, you know, the black chromosome's kind of passing a little bit of its genes onto this red one, and this red chromosome's kind of passing a little bit of its genes onto this black one. That's called crossing over, and that can also help create, you know, genetic variation. We can also think about, you know, like which sperm fertilizes the egg, because I mean there's thousands of sperm that, you know, don't make it, you know, one out of that thousand, that obviously is genetic variation, as well as from a larger standpoint, which mate they decide to choose. You know, maybe you know, they decide to, you know, the mate in which they decide to choose, you know, has a really big deal on a genetic variation of their offspring.